In this course, we will provide an in-depth overview of Dynamo, a visual programming plugin for designers. We will look at the node system and interoperability workflows to integrate computational design capabilities into your design workflow. We will start by introducing visual programming and data flow so we can see how Dynamo workflows can be created. Then, we will get into data types and how to work with code blocks to drive parameters more efficiently. Lastly, we will look at expanding functionality through custom Python scripting, as well as methods for packaging our own scripts for future simplified use. Dynamo is an open source visual programming tool that is enabled to work cross-platform with various industry tools to maximize workflow. And most of these workflows we will be working within the Dynamo sandbox environment. With that in mind, these lessons will prepare you to work within Dynamo and a variety of its supported environments. These environments include, but are not limited to, Autodesk Revit, Formit, Advanced Steel, Civil 3D, and Robot Structural Analysis. Let's go ahead and look at the basic interface features. The Dynamo tab contains various information related to your Dynamo install, as well as user preferences. These preferences cover everything from the current Dynamo settings to file locations. We will cover the preferences that are available to you in greater depth in a later video. The File tab contains your generic file manipulation methods, such as create a new file, either a home workspace or custom node, open an existing file, open a recent file, save the current file, or save as to save the current file as a different file with a different file name. This menu also contains export features, which include image export for the canvas, background export for 3D previews, and STL exports. STL is a file format that is commonly used in 3D printing. The Edit tab contains undo, redo, copy and paste interactions. It is worth noting that these typical keyboard shortcuts that you're familiar with do work as well. These shortcuts are indicated next to the command in the menu. The Edit tab also contains note creation options, which will come in handy for breaking down your workflow. To further document your Dynamo graphs, grouping commands are accessible from this menu as well. Alignment options are also very useful in maintaining a neatly organized workspace. Keep in mind, we will cover Dynamo graph annotations in greater detail in another video. The View tab gives us access to our basic navigation controls that can be used in a variety of ways. These include zoom commands for zooming in and out, and pan commands for panning around the canvas. Within the View tab, we also have the option to show a console, which is very useful for debugging, which we will cover in a future video. There are also different options for modifying the visualization of the workspace, such as toggling connectors on and off, or showing tooltips. We are also able to control the background 3D preview within this menu as well. The Packages menu offers the ability to search for and install packages which extend the usability of Dynamo. We will also cover this in a later video. Finally, the Help tab offers a series of Dynamo-related resources. I encourage you to take a look at these resources as you get started in Dynamo. There are topics in here such as getting started, interactive guides, samples, links to the Dynamo website, to the Dynamo Project Wiki, and other very helpful resources available to you. Within Dynamo, if we navigate down a bit from the menus, we will see a tab system that represents a current graph or where we currently are. At this point, we are on the landing page of Dynamo, which should look and feel pretty familiar. For this example, I'm going to go ahead and click on New. As you can see, our tab system now has a tab named Home. This is a new unsaved Dynamo graph. At the bottom of our window, we also have our console showing. If you were following along and enabled the console under the View tab, you can go ahead and click on Show Console to hide it. With our current workspace titled Home open, it is important to note that you can only have one main Dynamo graph open at a time. To begin programming, nodes are placed in the workspace and then connected with wires. The node library, located on the left side of your screen, serves as a browser for picking and searching nodes. The node library is broken down into categories that expand out into a directory type format. In order to get started, I'm going to go ahead and navigate to Geometry, Points, Point, and place the Bi-coordinates node. Once we click the node, we will notice that it is added to the workspace. We'll also notice a blue border surrounds the node. This indicates that the node is currently selected. We can zoom into the selected node by clicking on the dashed icon in the upper right corner. We can delete the node by right-clicking on it and selecting the delete option, or simply by pressing the delete key on your keyboard. There are a series of Dynamo sample files that are associated with the content shown in these tutorials. These can be accessed at dynamobim.org/learn. After we navigate to dynamobim.org/learn, you can click on the dataset link to download the dataset. After downloading, you will have to unzip the dataset to have all the files available to you. We can open the first file by navigating to File, Open. You might be prompted to save your current workspace. Since we didn't do anything in that graph, we can go ahead and click No. And we can navigate to where you downloaded the sample files and select the first sample file titled 01 Getting Started with Dynamo.dyn. As you can see, we have an option in the bottom portion of this window to open in manual execution mode. Go ahead and leave that checked for now, and we'll discuss that here in a bit. Select Open. Once we have the sample file open, we can see the workspace contains a series of elements including nodes, notes, and groups. This is commonly referred to as a definition or a graph. By default, Dynamo operates in a manual run mode, which means the data is updated whenever you select Run in the bottom left corner of the screen. Let's go ahead and select Run now. We can see the watch node contains the coordinates of a Cartesian point. This represents the output of the previous two nodes. This manual run mode operation can be modified by selecting the dropdown in the bottom left corner of the screen and selecting automatic. With that selection changed, as you make changes to the workspace, it will update in a live manner. In addition to a watch node to visualize the data coming out of the workflow, we are also able to use an additional node called Watch3D. Let's go ahead and navigate to our library and search for this now. We'll type Watch3D. Once again, clicking on the node places it on the workspace. If we connect the output of the point by coordinates node by selecting the output port and connect it, we will see that we have an option to view this point within this Watch3D node. To navigate a Watch3D node, we simply press and hold the middle mouse button to pan, the right mouse button to orbit, and the middle mouse button scroll to zoom. We are able to resize this node by clicking on the drag handle in the bottom right corner. This holds true for the regular watch node as well. These 3D watch node controls stay true for navigating the background 3D preview of Dynamo as well. In the top right corner of our graph, we will notice a geometry icon. Selecting this icon allows us to navigate the background geometry preview. If you hover on this icon, you will notice a keyboard shortcut available to us. In addition to navigating in that manner, you can simply hold down the escape key and navigate the 3D background. To save the Dynamo graph, we can navigate to File, Save, to save it, or simply press Ctrl S on your keyboard. To save a new version of this graph, we can use the Save As option. We simply click Save As, add a new name, and select Save. We've now saved this Dynamo graph as a modified version. Dynamo files use a .dyn extension. This is to eliminate any confusion with any other products that Dynamo is integrated with. With that complete, you've successfully opened your first Dynamo graph, navigated it, and saved it. To recap, in this video we covered what Dynamo is, the user interface in Dynamo, and a few of the common commands that are available to us. Next, we will cover strategies for documenting and creating clean Dynamo graphs.